Laminating with or without Coremat starts with applying a layer of resin to the mold surface. It is important to back wet fiber layers, which prevents air entrapment even after rolling the deaeration roller. The first layer of glass is rolled thoroughly into the resin before adding more resin as required.
We recommend to apply the Coremat on a wet or slightly gelled glass layer to get an optimal bond between the core and the glass. We do not recommend to wait until it's fully cured. Should your project not allow this, we recommend to sand the laminate before applying the Coremat, even if you've used a peel ply.
Next up is the Coremat. For this panel, we use the 4mm Coremat XM. The 4mm thickness creates the stiffness in this panel that we need for the application. It is important for the panel strength to fully wet out the Coremat. To make sure we fully wet out the Coremat, we pre-wet the front side of the Coremat, which is the smoother side. We can roll the resin in the Coremat without applying any force. We just have to make sure that the resin is spread over the surface of the Coremat. To accomplish this, we use long motions, stretching the full length and the full width of the ply. When we see resin remaining on the surface, we can turn over the Coremat to the backside and position it on the glass fiber. This should be done for all Coremat products of 3mm thickness or more. On the backside, we can see that the core is not fully wetted yet. This is why we use this two-staged approach. Now we can proceed with saturating the core. We do not have to measure the amount of resin we use because it's not possible to overfill the Coremat. The structure of the fibers and microspheres are chemically bonded to each other, so it will not expand when resin is added. Now that we are confident enough resin is applied, we can check the saturation level using our roller.
When we move our roller over the Coremat, again without using force or pressure, there should be a small front of resin being pushed by the roller. When this is the case all over the ply, we are done laminating Coremat.
We apply the second layer of glass fiber to the back side of our panel on the still wet Coremat. Do not allow the resin in the Coremat to cure when there is still excess on top. Instead, always laminate a thin layer of glass fiber on top and peel ply as needed. Coremat is a core material, and by far the best results in panel strength and durability are obtained when the coremat is laminated in the middle between fiber reinforcement layers. When we are confident the glass layer is fully saturated, we can apply a peel ply to cover the backside. Peel ply removes excess resin after cure and creates a good surface for coating or adhesive. Although peel ply is not a structural layer, we make sure that the layer is fully saturated.
After laminating, we let the resin cure for 24 hours at room temperature and post-cure it at 80 degrees centigrade. This is to make sure that the polyester is properly cured. What did you think of this video? And what are your tips for laminating coremat? Please leave your comments below and subscribe to our channel for more videos on Lantor and our products.
Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook and Twitter for more updates from Lantor. And should you have any technical questions about our Lantor product, you can always contact us on lantor.com.